Hey, what is up guys? Welcome to AXT. And one of the most obvious frustration in our daily life is the bottlenecking. Whether it will be in your traffic jam, maybe in a canteen, or maybe in your PC. Well, hard disk or mechanical drives can be a huge bottleneck in your PC due to the speed. Usually, modern CPU and GPU are really fast, but due to slow hard disk, your GPU and CPU cannot utilize its power. We cannot stick in this problem for always, can we? So, SSD was made. So, you finally thought to upgrade into SSD for your boot drive. And then, when you're up and running, something seems a little off. Then you realize the speed is still bottlenecking. Well, underwhelming SSD's performance can be a huge problem. But, solution may be lying under your UEFI BIOS, which you might have never checked. So, did you ever wonder about how your hard disk talks to your processor? I mean, most modern HDDs or SSDs can be operated by IDE or AHCI mode. Too complicated? Well, back then when you were a kid, you might have seen this fat gray ribbon cable to connect your hard disk into motherboard. Well, that's a parallel ATA connector and use the IDE standard. That was used for a long time and also was fine for mechanical drives or HDD. Parallel ATA had a speed limit to 133 megabytes. I mean, 133 megabytes was really dope and more than enough for a mechanical drive at that time. Unless SATA was out or the serial ATA that most of us use today. This is smaller in size and handles the modern HDDs and SSDs. Well, serial ATA not only it handles IDE standard, which has limited speed and a lot slower for this new SSDs, obviously, but it can also utilize a new standard called Advanced Host Controller Interface, or AHCI. Well, AHCI is fast, faster than the older standard. Also, AHCI supports hot swapping. Now, you don't have to turn off your computer for removing a device from eSATA. Yeah, you had to turn off your PC to remove a drive long back. That's pretty funny, right? Also, AHCI supports native command queuing, or NCQ. This helps the drive to handle multiple requests to fetch data at one time in HDD. HDDs are mechanical drives. It has physical moving parts inside it. So in HDD, using NCQ means it doesn't have to move the read and write heads much to access a piece of file. Basically, NCQ increases the life of the hard disk and increases the access speed. So, how the heck does NCQ helps SSD? I mean, SSDs are solid, no moving parts inside it. Well, that's for sure that NCQ helps SSD very negligible amount, a tiny bit. But many users found that using AHCI mode increases the performance greatly compared to the IDE mode. But why people use IDE mode? Well, if you see, if you want to run an older Windows, like Windows XP, you need to have the IDE mode. Because Windows XP doesn't support this new standard AHCI. Since AHCI is only designed with modern drives in the mind. I mean now, in 2018, AHCI is available in every computers and started to get a little old. So now, people want more faster drives. Well, there is one more standard, which is even more faster than AHCI. And it doesn't use the serial ATA, but instead, it uses the PCIe Express. That's the new sexy NVMe standard. We started to gain the popularity. Well, a maximum speed that a normal SATA 3 with AHCI can provide is up to 600 megabytes per second. But a PCIe Express with NVMe standard can speed up to 4 gigabytes per second. NVMe is only specially made for SSDs, since SSDs bottlenecks in SATA 3. Well, that's a whole new story. Click the I button to check the video what NVMe is about. So, that's AHCI. Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you think this video helped you, make sure you hit that like button. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And if you don't subscribe to my channel, an invisible hamster will die. And if you think this video sucked, then do whatever you wish to do. Until then, see you guys in the next video. Yo, yo.